Hello, everyone. I thought I'd do something. It's a rainy day here, and I thought I would do something a little cheery. So this is a photograph I got in a calendar. And one thing you might notice about this is there's no shadows. And they do this, I don't know why they do it. I guess to make it easier to view, but it lacks depth when it doesn't have shadows. So we will have to add those things. I also am going to do this, so we'll be adding shadows, and I'm going to do this piecemeal. So I'm going to, I've done the drawing here, and I'm going to, these spots here are the places I want to leave white, and one of the things, and then I'm just going to kind of start blocking things in, so I'm bringing those lines down a little bit. I don't want them to show. All right, so we've got the stones. We've got some hardscape and some softscape, which is what attracted me to this. So we've got the stones with lichens on it, but I'm not sure I'm gonna put that in. And then we've got the stone wall, and then we've got four pots and a lot of green. So one thing you might wanna consider doing is not painting the whole thing. So, I mean, there's a painting right there by itself. Let's see what else we can find. Here's a painting. Here's a painting. And there's all sorts of ways that you can break this up. So be sure and decide what you want to paint in this reference. So we're going to go light to dark. And I'm using a fairly soft brush. This is a Stephen Quiller. I think it's synthetic, but it's fairly soft. And I may actually end up going to one of my sables, which I think I might. So, because I don't want too many hard edges. So we've got the whites where we aren't gonna paint. Our next light color would be yellow, and I'm just gonna drop in that yellow. We've got some pinks over here, and I'm gonna try and leave some white edges around things too, to make it fresh looking. All right, let's see what happens. All right, let's start with the yellow over here. And this is really an acidic yellow, so I'm gonna use lemon. And Nicolazo. All right. So just we got some down here, some here, some here. Some here, kind of triangular shape. I'm just getting the basic idea of it here, moving up the page. And I'm not sure I like the idea of the yellow only being on this side of the painting. So I may let's put a couple little ones in there. Yeah, we got a little bit up here. Got some going off. Got a big one going off. Yep. Quite a bit. All right. So I think I need it in other places in the painting to be interesting. I don't want the colors all to be separated. So in the way that the red moves from here to here to here to here to here, I think we want the yellow to do the same. So I think I'm gonna put some yellow down here. I'm gonna make those that are pink, I'm gonna make them yellow. And then I'm just gonna put some small yellow, even though there isn't any flowers there, we're just gonna drop it in. So we've got the yellow moving through. We could even put a little up here. All right. So another thing to note is the different sizes of the groups of yellow that we've chosen to do. I'm gonna make this one a little bit bigger. So here's our large, a medium, put another one there, another medium, and a small. All right, so first color's done. We're just gonna let that be for now. And we could have painted this whole area yellow and then negative painted around it with blue or green, but I wanna keep it fresh. So I'm gonna try slightly different this time. All right, so let's, next up is some Queen Rose. And a little bit of Queen Fuchsia. So we'll start with the lightest pinks first, and they're all down here. So at this point, I'm not even gonna look at the reference. Change the direction of my brush. We'll change the direction of the shapes that come out over this. And actually go behind and down here. And we've got a big pink eye here, some white in the middle. And let's go with a different pink down here. Throw a little of the All right, we got a little bit of that pink up here coming along beside the pot. And then we got some pink over here. Try and leave that center of that pansy or that petunia, please. And another one here. And there's another one here. And there's some hanging over here. I think we got it. There's one back here. It's like a puzzle. All right, let's go to the red. So this is a mixture of quinacridone red and either organic vermilion or permanent or pyrrole orange, permanent orange. All right. Now we want to leave those white spaces. I don't want to mess with them. This one's looking that way. We got one down here. We got some over here. It doesn't have to be a flower, remember? It only has to feel like a flower. So we've got our pinks moving through, we got our reds moving through. We're gonna actually put one up here. I think that's a strawberry vine. It's got a couple of them there. these in here. So they have a round shape, but it's not a clear round shape. It's a varied round shape. So this is moving up this way. We need to move some over here as well. And we've got ours over here. Lots of them. And these we don't have to worry about the centers. All right, so we've got our red moving nicely through, and that just leaves purple. And normally I am such a big fan of Moon Glow, but Moon Glow does not look like a flower color to me necessarily, especially in this photo. I see a red we missed. All right. I think we've got it all. So there's our flower array. And let's start with the hard part, which is the green. And we're gonna put the rocks in last because they are behind. All right, let's see what we can build for green. And I'm going to try and make make our greens different for the different size plants. This comes down here. So I'm painting this one right now. And it's a mixture of, I don't know, it's our same yellow, but I threw some green in there. Comes right over to here. There's some little bits of it that have dropped down on the ground there. All right, let's bring that green. I'm gonna throw in a little more yellow. I'm going to create the edge here. Leaving some white. Right up inside these pansies. There's some darks in there that I don't have to worry about right now. Oh, there's another purple I missed. Well, I'll just paint around it and put it in later. Let's go up here. And this pretty much encircles our white flowers. Some hanging over the edge here. And I'm going to throw a little bit of a darker green in here while it's wet. Coming back here. So these petunias all have that same color. Leaf. So there's a little bit of white left there. Going to leave a little room for that pot here. All right. So we need to put some green up here for this flower and also for this flower. But that yellow is going to need a different treatment back there. Oh, went into my whites. Oh, that's all right. Oops. Boo-boo. All right, let's play with a slightly different green. So wherever you start with your brush, that's going to be the narrowest point. Whenever the brush is down, it thickens. As you go. This just becomes a giant. We needed to get some of that lighter green in there. We'll get that. All right, I've put this irregular shape at the bottom because we've got other leaves coming in there. I do want to get this darker in here. All right, I'm going to come over here and I don't know what I'm going to do. I'll leave some white. right down to our yellow. Let's go back to that lighter one. We've got some alyssum down here, which even is lighter. So I'm going to give that a And we've got some brown along that edge, so this is a good time to do that. I'm just gonna mix some of our red that we've got and some of our green and come in and put that in there. Now we've got some blue green. So I'm going to take some straight up perylene green, dilute it. In there, and we're going to use a little bit more of it over here. We've got nasturtiums, which have a center that is white, so I think I'm going to keep it like this, and I'm going to let it set for a minute, and then I'm going to come in and change that center. So it's not a pure white, so I'm just going to away some of the color if I can, so the edge stays dark. Comes all the way over here. Didn't work as well as I wanted, so I'll wait till it sets up a little more and then come back and lift. Let's see if we can get this to work. So I can actually drop a little bit of water in there, and that's going to move the color away, as you can see. Doing the work for me, yay. All right, now up here, we have a grass. And I'm gonna put it all in with the very lightest yellow, green, and then come back later and define it. So, this comes all the way to the edge. And becomes quite solid. It's really quite a lovely garden. It's just not a good photograph of it. So we'll just make it what we want it to be. Some straight yellow in there. It gets darker. So it comes down, and we've got to paint around the stems and leaves of these flowers. Maybe we'll put them in first. We've got a little bit of alyssum over here too. Pretty much miss this pot. Our white flowers are starting to look white now. And let's go back to our brown. Put some of that in. Some of it up here. We have some more feathery. All right, so we got this feathery green stuff up here, which I'm not loving. So I'm not gonna put it behind the flower pot, but I will put some kind of feathery, evergreeny thing. Over this way. They're like a bunch of little Christmas trees. Some kind of brown thing over here. Just gonna drop a couple of little red dots in there. All right, I think we can block in the pots at this point. We've got all this over here to do green. I'm just going to color this in because it is all green. And we'll come back and so this is more of a spiky plant. This color comes all the way down. And I'm going to put in the pots and then I'm going to turn you loose and I will finish this and we have more of this in front of this. That does not thrill me. Definitely an evergreen of some kind. And it goes way up the pot, but I'm not going to do that. To the stones. Now, I could have painted that all green and put the black over it, but that would lose its crispness, and we don't want to do that. All right. Next up is pots. I'm using quinacridone burnt orange, which is a clearer kind of sienna. I'm not going to do the stones yet, just the pots. More intensity in there. So I'm just putting the, so we're going to do glazing with this. I'm just putting the lightest layer in. I'm not going for intensity at this point. I just want to get the basic colors in. It's looking okay. This pot is white, so we're just going to paint around it. Well, it's partly white. then we've got our black one over here, which I'm not going to make completely black. I'm mixing our green with our purple. Some brown down here. And missed some green in here. Actually, there's a lot more green in there. All right, it's starting to look like a garden. So this guy comes up much higher and comes all the way over. a little more intensity in there. All right, now we've got rocks. Now these rocks are pretty sienna colored. The ones on the wall, some of them are, but not so much. So we'll put the sienna ones in. So that'll bring the color up. It's a busy place. It is a very busy place. So I mixed a little bit of our green with the sienna. We get this nice brown. Don't worry about the mortar, we'll get that. I really don't want to smooth out that color. I want it to be a little irregular because rocks are. So I'm just going to leave that. So it's all very middle value right now. Obviously, the painting is not, or the photograph is not middle value. So that's when we go back and build. So mixing the browns, let's go back now and do some developing. These are pretty dry. So I'm gonna take just a little bit of green and kind of pull it into my white. I'm gonna take some of my dark green and drop it into my petunias. And you don't want to do just circles, because it's not really like that. So you want to make it more interesting shapes. Now I'm going to come back with my red and just kind of draw some of the dark away in some spots. Give it a little more jazz. All right, let's put some of the dark darks in, and I'm going in with pretty straight green mixed with a little bit of burnt sienna. So I'm gonna make the assumption the light is coming this direction, so that's gonna make this the darkest. Over here. And especially down here, where it's blocked by the plants. The light is not getting through there. Take some of the black off of my brush. This is very dark brown. So if you squint, you'll see where the very darks are. Here, 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 here. So we're not trying to paint the garden like a photograph. We're trying to paint the garden how it feels. The fullness of it. All right. I'm gonna come down here and some darks in there. I'm not going to worry about the design on that pot. But you can. This won't be our last layer of this. So if the light is coming this way, and it's nature, the lightest part is always the top, but then this would be slightly darker. Rocks. All right, we've got some. Since the light's coming this way, there are no shadows on this, but we can put some back here because it's back farther. All right, let's come back to more fun things. I'm letting that sit for a minute. I'm gonna go in and play with it. Quite so many hard edges in there. texture. So all the way up. We've got a piece of stone we missed here. All right, I think that's more than enough to get you started. I'll finish this and we'll see how you do.